Hello!
How are we doing?
It's Fanta. So, Andrew's brought some beers. I've purchased some. I don't really buy much beer these days. I mostly do my ale trails. But Andrew purchased this.
It's a little shop in Horsham. Very nice little shop. It has his real ales, craft beers and everything in there. Really nice. I saw these ones. I thought, yes. Gotta try these ones. Mm. It's got whiskey in it. And these are like coated in wax as well.
Yeah. Which is a popular thing. Yeah. It helps stop the beer progressing in certain ways because it's whenever you bottle a beer, oxidation goes in there and it alters it to a degree. So this is the way I've slowed it down, I think. This is Dr. French's 2017 Whiskey Rye Tomato. Whiskey barrel age for 1 year.
It sounded good already with brewed, the whiskey in it.
Yeah, it's brewed and bottled by Welton's Brewery. I've never had one from Welton's Brewery. It's from West Sussex.
It's quite local then.
Is it to you?
West Sussex, yeah. West Sussex. Quite local. I thought it might be Scottish whiskey then. You know, like the top, because the Thomas, there's a Scottish distillery called Tomatin. I've tried their whiskey.
Yes! It's got a bunch of stuff in here. Do the honours. So you get a little pamphlet with this. It tells you about Tomatol, which is pretty cool. Which I think is a great idea. Yeah. If you're going to do a bottle or a can or whatever. It should come with a little pamphlet telling you about the whiskey that it's been put in.
Very
smart. So it shows that you can enjoy it as much.
You do get that whiskey burn.
The gentle dram. Now, Andrew's a whiskey lover. And I started out whiskey when I first started. A dram is basically a shot of.
Yeah. On this, what I'm getting. There's a
candle in there. Candle.
Yeah. Wax in it. You see it?
Issues. But anyway, I'll get it. I'll use it.
Let's see, smell the wax. Show me the fresh one.
Yeah, I'll leave that to the side.
There we go. Yeah, lovely, nice caramel note to it, you know what I mean? You do get the whiskey feel, very malty, very rich. Clings to your back of your throat as well.
Try to drink it, so
you get that wax bit.
I've got it. Lovely beer.
Yeah, very
What's
nice.
The ABV on this beer?
So, it balanced 8.2%.
I can just see it getting better and better.
Well, like I said, it's aged for 1 year. And if you let it mature a bit more, you can only get better.
And it's till 2020, and it's 2018 now.
So you can like leave it for another 2 years.
Oh wow,
and it'll be really tasty.
That's cool how it comes with a pamphlet. I reckon that's
the
first.
It says there the type of whiskey that the beer is aged in, you know, the barrels that is.
I think that's a good idea. But the next beer is one from Tahul. Now, Tahul means the beer. This is a Santos Secret.
Which, this place is, where is it from? Is it from Copenhagen or?
Denmark.
Denmark.
So where did you buy this one from, Andrew?
Well, this one as well, I picked up from
the bottle shop.
From Not the bottle shop.
Oh, the brewery.
The brewery, Augsburg Brewery. Really good place to visit.
8%. So this is Santa is a badass.
Because they had a lot of Christmas beers in.
Oh, it's a Christmas beer, this.
And this is the Danish Christmas beer from Tool. Santa's Secret. Mm.
Is it Sweden that celebrate their Christmas in January? I can't remember.
Yeah.
But, yeah, dark in colour. Reddish brown.
Like a rye.
Climbing chimney. Santa is a badass riding reindeers, climbing chimneys, and still being the kids' number one hero. What is secret to success? Buckets of mochaccinos, double shot. So it's double shot mochaccino.
You get definitely a nice sweet chocolate.
Get a coffee, definitely. Sharp bitterness.
I wouldn't show on the coffiness, but is it, you get that chocolatey taste.
You get a little bit of shot of cola almost. That's nice. The coffee's I thought it'd fit through it really quickly though.
Yeah. I didn't get much of the coffee, but I got a nice sweet chocolatey.
Let's have a look. This is one I've been looking forward to when Andrew got it. This is a really beautiful label.
When they told me about this beer, I was like, it sounds interesting because the honey they use in this beer, it's straight out of London. Bees kept on top of flats and stuff like that, I think it was, basically. They call it urban honey.
Yeah, we had an urban honey beer a while ago, when we first started reviewing beers. The beer was called Ivor. And I don't know if you remember, but it would mostly just, it tastes like soda water.
Yeah.
And really bad. I think it was just basically badly kept the bottle, maybe. But the branding, though, that's beautiful. Mm. Because London the way it is, they have the ives on top of the and they save all the bees up there. And so basically, you can have ivories all over. Not ivory, ivers, sorry.
Yeah.
Ivories, that's what we nothing.
Yeah.
But,
I mean, see, ives from the bees, basically.
We get quite a lot in Yorkshire, and
we have a friend that does keep a lot of hives all along the east coast of Yorkshire.
It's an art form. Pearly Queen Beer Company, apparently.
Ooh, that's
nice. Pearly Queen is a collective of urban beekeepers. So that's what it means is basically it's just like almost a society of basically when that person takes care of it, the other person doesn't, and then also, so.
You get like honey syrup? Really nice.
I think, what was that?
That's not too bad actually, it's like quite light and floral. You get that sweet honey coming through. It's like honey lager, rather than a honey pale ale.
I see what you mean. I just had some comment on the video the other day, the Pearl of Honey, which is one of Andrew's favourites, as well as Two Chefs, which is St. Peter's did a really nice honey
porter. Oh, that was really nice. So that good. Did smell like honey. It smells like does smell like honey.
But we've noticed when we've had honey beers before, it's very hard to detect sometimes. Yeah. But you do detect it in the sweet elements.
Like with making honey itself is really hard to technique. You're comparing the glucose, so it's like the syrupy part of it all.
But
to get that honey taste.
It's nice to see all these different breweries that I didn't know about, and I get to try them. And branding is on form. It's beautiful how it's wrapped around the bottle. It's got like a fairy.
But you definitely get that honey taste, you know what I mean? That honey, floral, sweet
taste. Oh, it's vegan approved as well, so if you're vegan, you can actually drink this beer. It comes with water, malted barley, raw honey, hops, and yeast.
Yep.
4.5%. Really nice beer.
Yeah.
So this is another beer that Andrew brought up. This is the Farmwise.
All Star Games.
Wise Chocolate.
The Ogsback Brewery.
Yeah.
Like I said, they have these foreign beers in there, which is really good choices in there. Like I said, as well as their own type of beers.
Yeah.
But yeah, good choices.
£3.80. Beautiful cap on.
Is it Danish or Bel?
I'll look in a minute.
Belgium. I think this one's a Belgium, I'm not sure.
Handcrafted in Belgium.
Yeah, because that's what I spotted. This beer is it handcrafted by Mulls, or is it, what's the story of say?
It's a sour beer.
Yeah.
Cool. It's got translations and stuff like that on the site. On our farm, we produce our own barley. So basically, the farm produces its own barley, wheat, spelt, and Magnum hops. So all produced all in-house.
You definitely get a sourness on the smell.
We make our beer that pairs chocolate with fruit. It's a smooth chocolate taste. We age the beer for 6 months on fresh fruit, then add the home-roasted chocolate beans. That's pretty cool that they actually do all that in-house.
Yeah.
Which are dry-hopped for 5 days. So the roasted chocolate beans are dry-hopped. And what that means is it doesn't mean it's a technique. It's the last thing you put into the beer before it's finished.
Mm.
It doesn't mean that it's opt. It means the last thing.
You get a very raspberry tarty taste to it, you know what I mean? And that no chocolate hint. But it's the raspberry of it.
Our fresh raspberries are processed the day they arrive at the farm to get the most flavour into the beer. That's pretty cool. All that technique goes into that beer.
Yeah. Very nice.
Yeah. It's a slight
get that sourness to it.
What's that smell? Almost like a malt vinegar. But
when I came to around buying this one, is the guy at the shop said recommended this one as well because the process to go on buying making this beer is really good. It's all homegrown, you know what I mean?
Yeah, it's pretty cool. That's a really tasty beer. What's the ABV on this beer?
So the ABV is 7%.
I think it's super drinkable. I think it's one of my favourites so far. And this beer is the final beer. Purchased it from the Triangle in Saltaire. It's a beer from Estonia, Poya and Odilp. It's a collaboration. It's an imperial porter with licorice, and it's 11%.
I kind of done
I think we've had that brew before. We've probably not reviewed anything from that brew, but I know we've had.
Yeah.
But I just recognise the leaf.
Mm.
But I remember Andrew likes his big boy beers and a beautiful cap on there.
Well, before I ventured out, I was trying the Omnipolo ranges, and a lot of the Omnipolo ranges were very peculiar, different tastes.
Yeah.
And I'm still interested there, you know what I mean, trying all these different craft beers.
I know that brewery is from Amsterdam, and that brewery is from Estonia, because I know I've had that brewery before.
And I don't know what they was partake in some of the Omnipolo ranges, though, did they?
No, one's Denmark, one's. But it's very similar name.
Yeah.
But that's pretty cool branding, though.
It smells very rich, chocolatey again.
Planet Uru, life form number 5. So it's like something out of X Files, almost.
Getting every type of licorice. It just reminds me of. That beer called Licorice Ale Sorts, very licorice, very tarty, you know what I mean?
But yeah, it's nice to try unique beers. How's the ABV testing?
Well, it is quite smooth, you can't recognise that it's 11%, but you do feel almost
that's what I'm missing out with the other beer. That's beautiful, but it's just textures there. That's a good beer.
Mm.
There's slight, almost like Weet-Bix-y aftertaste. It's like a cereal here in the UK.
Well, like a shredded wheat, sort of.
Yeah, oh yeah. Because Andrew used to like Weet-Bix when he was... He used to mix them with cornflakes.
Mm, mixing it up, you know what I mean?
Chocolatey, a little bit of raisin.
Mm.
That's a nice beer.
Very now, nice.
Out of the five, I'd have to say my favourite, probably the sour.
Yeah.
That it just totally surprised me. I didn't know it was sour, but when as soon as I started drinking it, I and this was really good.
Mm.
As the night progresses, I'm sure it'll just improve. But out of those two, yeah.
I did like the honey and pale ale, that was nice.
Yeah, that was good.
But I think they've all been pretty good though.
Yeah. So out of the five, which would you buy again?
They're quite close to each other.
No, it's
I'd say the whiskey rye.
So it's I'll lean towards that because that was a good beer, and you could just tell it was going to get better.
Yeah.
So that out of the five, if you see that, buy that. Thank you, Andrew. It's all good in the hood.
Enjoy these.
You take care.
Go back.
Bye.